Welcome to the M3 Bear Essentials. My name is Malcolm Travers.
Section called Why I Choose to Thirst Trap. So let's start with some definitions. The thirst trap, is any social media post that is designed to grab attention based on hotness. And the reason this person said he chooses a thirst trap is because he was picked on as a kid, as a young gay black man, and now that he has bloomed into a hot older gay black man, he wants to flaunt it. And it's his prerogative. And he said most of the times when people say he's thirst trapping, it's usually friends who are picking on him. But now he's like, I am not ashamed. I am a thirst trapper. I post hot selfies of myself on social media. And I bask in the glow of my comments and likes.
Oh, jeez.
See, to me, that's already going to, for me, I say you're recreating that whole back in the day where you got teased, because you opening up the floodgates for that to happen again. And as an adult, depending on your self-esteem, it could be worse. Could be worse.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants a compliment. Now, mind you, some people are more thirsty for the compliment more than others. Mm-hmm. But, you know, none of us take a picture, post a picture on Facebook when we just first woke up with boogers in our eyes and slobber down our mouth. You know what I'm saying? We're putting our best picture that we possibly can, and even this for a profile picture. Mm. So we want to look good so people can go like, oh, he's cute. Mm. Not desperation. We're not trying to beg and please, please, please for a compliment. Mm. But we all do it. Mm. And, you know, if you are single, I can see how you can expand that and maybe have the picture go down a little lower and a little lower and a little lower and naked. And booty cracks spreading open, because we all, you know, people just want that compliment. I mean, I definitely, like, I say that because I definitely stand in judgment of people who do that, but when I really start to think about it and go, like, I do the same thing. And so does everybody. It's just the different levels of it. Hmm. And if you're out there looking for a relationship or looking for a hookup, I can see how you would, you know, put a lot of good-looking pictures of yourself out there. Hmm. Clearly, you can go too far. Because I'm not going to name names, but there are quite a people on the internet, particularly in the black gay universe, who post 20 selfies a day.
Yeah.
And they all look exactly the same. Like, it's the same picture like this, but just in different clothes.
And different backgrounds.
Different yeah, different.
And he changing scenery.
Hey, y'all. What are y'all doing? Like, that's shit that's annoying, but, you know, we all do it. We all post. I mean, that's the purpose of a selfie, is for somebody to think of it. Mm-hmm. I mean, come on. Let's be real about it.
I think it's borderline narcissistic, if anything, to some degree.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. Mm-hmm. No doubt. But I don't know how much of a bad thing that is, I guess is what I'm saying.
I guess it depends. It really depends on the person on how bad it is.
Mm-hmm. And I think definitely, you know, I definitely stand in judgment if it, you know, just for me and my weird sensibilities, you know, I definitely stand in judgment if there's like a whole bunch of, you know, if I'm getting like proctological views of you, like, I don't need to see your ass spread open so I can see your spleen. I don't need to see that. You know, I don't need to see if there's any polyps up there. I'm just chilling on Facebook. I don't need to see all that. But, you know. Everybody, we've all posted a selfie. All of us have posted a selfie.
Yeah.
I guess I definitely think it's something different if you lean over to 20 a day. Then it's kind of like, you know, you might want to get a dog to get some attention.
Yeah.
just get a puppy. Just get a puppy.
Yeah.
He'll love you no matter what you look like. Just get
exactly.
A puppy.
Yeah.
I don't know. I read the article and it just... Yeah, I get that you get your ass handed to you in a looks department growing up. You know, I did too. I mean, I post a picture because I feel like, you know, sharing a picture. I don't know. It just rubbed me the wrong damn way for some reason. I'm like, dude, you don't have to say I'm a thirst trapper. I mean, it's just like, because to my mind, if I like your picture, Well, if I like your picture, in my mind, you sitting back there giggling like, yeah, this motherfucker, you know, he's thirsty. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He's thirsty. I mean, but if I want to admire your picture and if it's not liking it, I shouldn't be called thirsty because, you know, you posted it. You know, if you want to, it's like a selfie. You post a picture of yourself in some underwear or something like that, I'm not thirsty by clicking on it. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, oh, cute. You know, click. Mm-hmm. And go by your biz, but you sit there like, because I just always look. I have one guy who always told me, yeah, I like to post to see how many people like on my pictures all the goddamn time. I'm like, that's fucked up. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, I stopped liking his pictures. Because, you know, people, he sat there putting something up like real, you know, like revealing himself. I don't give a fuck now because you're telling me that everybody, you talk about everybody who's posting the pictures, like, oh, this person right here is thirsty, this person right here is thirsty, that person right there is thirsty, so.
This is my thing. How do you tell a person is thirsty just based off them liking a picture? Yeah. Because you really have to know that person and their personality in order to get the gist of their thirstiness, I guess, more or less.
Yeah. That's my thing. It's weird.
I mean, I don't see anything wrong with provocative photos, I guess. But I think we probably need to define the idea of like a thought photo.
Yeah.
The difference between a thought photo and a provocative photo. Hey, for example, a thought photo. Or it's more like a video. For example, bus going past. One particular night, a gentleman sent both me and Malcolm, mind you, because I don't think he knew that we were together. So I think he was just trolling around on the internet and was trying to find cute big boys and sent the both of us videos of himself in bed going like, hey, sexy. And he was bucket naked. And the bed was filled with flowers. And then I got it, and I think that Malcolm got it. And it was like, did you just get a video? And he was like, yeah, I just got a video.
Oh, my God.
It was really bad because I was in public when I got it, too. And I opened
it
up.
Wow.
I was like, dude, did you just get a video from this dude? He was like, yeah. Because I think in mine, he was in bed, and then in Malcolm's, he was in front of the mirror with chocolates and shit in front of the bed. Anyway, I'm going to dress her. That's a very thoughtful video. So that, for example, I will not do. Like, you know, I won't do that. But particularly if I like a good workout, whenever that happens, whatever day that happens in the future. Or if I happen to get like a really interesting angle in which I'm halfway naked and it covers a lot of the flab and I'm kind of naked, I would probably take a picture. Because I was like, ooh, you know, whatever. I don't think that's a thoughtful picture. I think that's a provocative, trying to make say you lead sexy picture. That's not a thoughtful picture. That's not me posting it out there saying, please, 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 I'm trying to get a date, I'm trying to get a hookup. That's just like, I'm really cute. Get into it. Damn. That's not a thoughtful picture.
Yeah, and I think there is a certain degree to which, you know, it is in the eye of the beholder kind of deal. And it's a judgment call that people make, because I think it's something Jawan says, like, how do you know that someone's being thirsty just by liking your picture? You don't. That's the answer. That's up in your head. That's what you think about. And there's really nothing you can really do to change someone else's opinion of that. Like I said, I had a friend who, you know, a dude smiling at him is being thirsty.
You know, thirsty. Like, yeah.
You know, like, that's a lot of inference you're making. Yeah, yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So.
Well, yeah. I was gonna just say I want to put it out there. I've did provocative photos, but I wouldn't call them thirst traps. But now that I'm like, I'm not trying to say that I'm high and mighty or anything like that. It's just, I just didn't think that somebody of their caliber would be out. I mean, how can I put it? If they post like a Breeze presented it as a provocative photo, or something that's showing like a bathroom selfie, that's fine. But it's just like, I wouldn't be, if I was in his shoes, I wouldn't say I'm a thirst trapper, knowing that I have all these, you know, accolades under my belt. It's just like, no, I post pictures, you know.
Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and share our content. more information, visit mailmediamind.com.